The second joyful mystery, the visitation of Our Lady to her cousin Elizabeth. The fruit of this mystery is the virtue of fraternal charity. The second song is another Ave Maria, composed this time by Jacobus Gallus in the 16th century again. This polyphony has been attributed to Thomas Louis de Victoria, a composer of the same period. We contemplate now the word of Saint Elizabeth to the Blessed Virgin Mary, the day of the Visitation. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The third joyful mystery, the Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ. The fruit of this mystery is the virtue of poverty. O Magnum Mysterium. This polyphony has been composed by Thomas Louis de Victoria in the 16th century. The text is coming from the Matins of Christmas. This song expresses the great mystery that has happened during the night of Christmas. We mentioned the animals, which according to a venerable tradition were present in the crib of Bethlehem. We insist on the Iacentem, lying down. The King of the universe is in a small manger. What a mystery. Then we are full of admiration in front of the divine motherhood of Our Lady. She is a creature and she bears her creator in her womb. Again, what a mystery. The translation of this song is, O great mystery and wonderful sacrament, that animals should see the newborn Lord lying in a manger. Blessed is the Virgin whose womb was worthy to bear the Lord, Jesus Christ. Alleluia. The fourth joyful mystery, the presentation of the child Jesus in the temple and the purification of Our Lady. The fruit of this mystery is the virtue of obedience and purity. The day of the presentation of Jesus in the temple, an old man called Simeon had the immense happiness of seeing his Savior. He was waiting for this moment since years. He had been waiting for this moment for so many years. For us, there is no need to wait years, as Jesus is present in the Holy Eucharist, really and substantially, in all the tabernacle of the world. The polyphony we will sing next is called O Salutaris Hostia, composed in the 20th century by Alexander Castor Skago. This song is a praise, in praise of the Blessed Sacrament. Originally composed for France, we have changed the name of France by Kenya. The translation of this song is O Salutary Victim, who opens the door to heaven for us. The enemy gives us battle, gives us power, strength and help. O truly worthy host, only hope of the faithful, Kenya confides in you. Give peace to the servant of the Virgin, to the Lord one, and enthroned be eternal glory, that he gives us in the fatherland the life that has no end. Amen. The fifth joyful mystery, the finding of the child Jesus in the temple. The fruit of this mystery, the seeking of God in everything. Our Lord Jesus Christ has been found by Saint Joseph and the Blessed Virgin Mary in the temple of Jerusalem after 3 days of searching. We also have to look for God in our life, to be thirsty of God, as the Psalm 42 suggests. The next polyphony called Sicut Servus has been composed by Giovanni Pierluigi de Palestrina in the 16th century and is a part of this Psalm 42. As the deer pants for streams of water, so my soul pants for you, O God. After the joyful mystery, the sorrowful mystery. In the joyful mystery, we contemplate the incarnation of our Lord, but we should never forget that if Jesus came in this world, it was for the sorrowful mystery, for the redemption of the world, to save us. We now contemplate the sorrowful mysteries, and we start with the first one, the agony of Jesus in the Garden of Olives. The fruit of the mystery, a great contrition for our sins. The song we are going to present now is called O Vos Omnes. The text is coming from the liturgy of the Holy Week, and the music has been composed by, again, Thomas Luis de Victoria in the 16th century. This song is a call to compassion. If we really love our Lord Jesus Christ, we cannot let him alone during his passion. The translation of this song is, O all of you who walk by on the road, pay attention and see. If there be any sorrow like unto my sorrow, pay attention all people and look at my sorrow, if there be any sorrow like my sorrow. Thank you. The second sorrowful mystery, the scourging at the pillar. The fruit of this mystery is the mortification for our sins committed with our senses. Kali gaverunt. My eyes are crying. This polyphony is also a song composed by Thomas Louis de Victoria for the Holy Week in the 16th century. This song is an invitation to contrition. When we see all what Jesus suffered for us, how can we be so insensible? How can we continue to sin? Translation of this polyphony is, my eyes are blinded from my tears, because far from me is anyone who will comfort me. See, all ye people, if there be any sorrow like unto my sorrow, O all of you who pass by the road, stop and see, if there be any sorrow like unto my sorrow.
Thank you.
The third, sorrowful mystery, the crowning with thorns. The fruit of this mystery is the mortification for our sins of pride. O sacred head surrounded. This song composed by Saint Bernard of Clairvaux in the 11th century in France has been set in music by Johann Sebastian Bach in the 18th century. We contemplate the crown of thorns of our Lord. It is a prayer of a soul deeply sorry for its sin, but at the same time full of gratitude. Jesus' passion and death have indeed opened for us the door of heaven.
Oh.
The fourth sorrowful mystery, the carrying of the cross. The fruit of this mystery, the virtue of patience in adversity. In the 20th century, Théodore Dubois composed his Adoramus Te, We Adore Thee. This song is an homage to our Lord Jesus Christ and to his cross. Indeed, without the cross, by which our Lord saved us, there would be no salvation. We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. The fifth sorrowful mystery, the crucifixion of our Lord. The fruit of this mystery, a greater love for the Holy Mass. O Memoriale. The following polyphony is a part of the hymn Adoro Te Devote, an hymn composed by Saint Thomas Aquinas in the 12th century for the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament. The Holy Eucharist is the fruit of the Mass, and the Mass is nothing else than the renewal of the sacrifice of the cross. We should never forget that. When we attend Mass, we are at the foot of the cross, and it must be shown in the way we behave. O memorial of our Lord's death, living bread that gives life to man, grant my soul to live on you, and always to savor your sweetness. Lord Jesus, good pelican, wash my filthiness and clean me with your blood, one drop of which can free the entire world of all its sins.
Amen.
After the sorrowful mystery, the glorious mystery. A Catholic is someone always happy, because he knows that after the cross, there is a resurrection. Above the clouds, there is always the sun. The goal, if our Lord died for us, it is to open the door of heaven for all of us. After the cross, there is always the resurrection. And it is what we contemplate in the first glorious mystery. The resurrection, the fruit of this mystery is the virtue of faith. Jesu Rex Admirabilis, Jesus Wondrous King. This song has been composed by Giovanni de Palestrina in the 16th century. We contemplate during this song the triumph of our Lord. It is also the prayer of a soul desiring to stay forever with the one she loves. The translation of this song, Jesus, wondrous King and noble conqueror, unutterable sweetness, wholly desirable, remain with us, Lord, and shine your light upon us, drive away the darkness of our minds, fill the world with sweetness. The second glorious mystery, the ascension of our Lord, the fruit of this mystery, the virtue of hope and a great desire for heaven. The day of ascension was a day of triumph in heaven and even on earth. Our Lord went back to his Father. After having been saved, now the doors of heaven are open for us. That should make us full of happiness and gratitude. The song we are going to present now is called Tollite Hostias. The text is coming from the Psalm 95. It has been put in music by Camille Saint-Saëns, a French, in the 19th century. The translation of this song is, "Bring offerings and adore the Lord in his holy place. Rejoice, heaven, and exult all the earth before the Lord, for he comes. Alleluia."
Tollite hostias, et
The third glorious mystery, the Pentecost. The fruit of this mystery is the virtue of charity and the apostolic zeal. The day of the Ascension, our Lord promised to send us a comforter. The Holy Ghost indeed came the day of the Pentecost to strengthen the apostles in their mission. The third person of the Holy Trinity continued to take care of its creature by visiting their souls and giving them its seven gifts. If ye love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth. This text is from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 14, verse 15 to 17. We read it the day of the Pentecost. These beautiful words of our Lord to his disciples have been set in music by Thomas Tallis in the 16th century. The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption of Our Lady in heaven. The fruit of this mystery, the grace of a holy death. Our Lady, like her divine Son, has gone to heaven with her soul and body. It is the truth of our faith. All the privileges she has been given are coming from her divine motherhood. She is the Mother of God. It is why she is the Immaculate Conception. It is why she went to heaven with her body and soul. The song we are going to present now is called Ave Verum. This song is illustrating the divine motherhood of the Blessed Virgin Mary. This song has been composed by William Byrd, an English composer in the 16th century. The translation of this polyphony, Hail, true body, born of the Virgin Mary, having truly suffered, sacrificed on the cross for mankind, from whose pierced side water and blood flowed, be for us a foretaste of the heavenly banquet in the trial of death. O sweet Jesus, O holy Jesus, O Jesus, Son of Mary, have mercy on me. Amen. The fifth glorious mystery and last mystery of this rosary, the coronation of Our Lady in heaven. The fruit of this mystery, a greater devotion to Our Lady. Stella Splendens. This song has been composed in Spain, in the Abbey of Montserrat, in the 14th century, and was sung by the many pilgrims who were coming to honor the Blessed Virgin Mary in this holy place. Let us, we too, unite our voices to their and honor our Mother of Heaven. A bright star miraculously shining on the mountain like sunshine. Hark the mass assembling, all people rejoicing. The rich and the poor, the greatest and the pettiest are gathering as well as we are self-witnessing. Let's all herald once more this Hail Mary. We are coming now to the end of this concert already. Another time we could even praise a decade together during this rosary. We just wanted today to continue this apostolate that we want to do with the choir of Holy Cross Catholic Parish, to spread this sacred music everywhere. It is the music that we are singing in the church since centuries. All the songs we are singing are coming from the 14th, 16th, 15th, 17th, 18th centuries. The Catholic Church has only one faith, only one baptism. The Catholic Church is for everybody. And we have, therefore, only one liturgy, with a common song, a common chant that we can sing in Kenya, but also in Japan, in France, in US, everywhere in the world. Let us continue to receive this treasure we have been given by our ancestors, and let us have the will to keep it and to give it to the next generation. These songs are beautiful, and they really have the power to change our souls. Let us be convinced of that. These songs have converted so many people. And if we were singing more this song today, maybe we could have even more conversion. Let us thank God for all his gift. Let us thank God for all these composers who compose so beautiful music. And the best way to thank our Lord for all that, it is maybe to sing all these songs more and more in our churches. We can finish this concert with a word of prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Immaculate Heart of Mary, our Holy Guardian Angel, Saint Joseph, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.